Hello everybody, it is Starlight Spin here, and today we are going to be doing a 5 model unboxing. As you can see, we have 5 new models, and all of these I think were released pretty much within this last month, and I just got them from Waffle Collectibles. I use Waffle quite a lot. They kind of have some mixed reviews. Every now and then somebody says, oh, don't order from them, blah blah blah, but honestly I have pretty good experiences with them. So as you can see, we got 5 new models from them, and I am just so thrilled to go through these in particular, mainly because we have finally some new models with the new livery, the new United livery, which has just been released, and they're on some pretty popular aircraft, as you can see, 737s, A320s. But we also have Delta aircraft, and you know, I'm kind of collecting my improving my collection for Delta aircraft at the moment, ordering some more A320s, you know, 739s, basic stuff. So as I saw these two aircraft, particularly that 739, I was just really happy to add that to my collection. So let's go through each of these aircraft individually. I'm going to give you my short thoughts. Just happy to do another 5 model unboxing. Just, it's been such a long time since I've uploaded like your basic model, you know, reviews and stuff on this channel. It's been so long. So let's make it exciting and let's move on to the Delta 737-900. And as you can see, it's got the split scimitars, and the real key with this model is that it doesn't have any markings. And when I say that, the previous 737-900s from Gemini Jets always had like a Spirit of Seattle or some other like title, and it used to be like right there on the nose. And to me, that just kind of bothers me, because I bet the model still, like the aircraft still flies, but I wanted something that's a little bit more clean. And you can see here, there's no markings on this. This is a classic 739 that you'll see any day. And as you can see, it's got the split scimitars, and just an overall good model. And the bigger thing about Gemini Jets that I've been hearing a lot of people say is their quality control issues. And when I say that, you get these models and pretty much they're broken. Either one of these wings is basically unstable, and it's to the point where it just gets insane. Like you get more models from them and you just keep, oh yeah, I'll just get another one, I'll get another one, but they keep having the same issues. And finally, this one didn't come with any issues. Maybe if you guys got some issues with these, you know, you let me know in the comments, but I'm really happy with this model anyway, so I don't have to send it back. And anyways, it's got some, you know, your basic details. I'm very happy with it. You know, it's got the antennas, which is a big improvement from previous Gemini Jets instances. And let's see, we have that satellite dish, which I always like. There's the nose of the aircraft, you know, basic view on the bottom, or, you know, the underbelly. We have a Delta logo, which looks good. Everything else, you know, it's a clean model. Looks good, man. You know, I'll take it. Very happy with that model. Up next, we have a Delta A320. And what's really interesting about this, I don't really know how to do this. I should probably just do it on its back. What's really interesting about this is that it's been so long since a Delta A320 has been released. I mean, in particular from Gemini Jets, I don't even know if, I think they did release an A320, but it has been so long, and that model is extremely hard to find. It's very, you know, it's just rare and it's expensive. So when Aero Classics came up with this model, I was very impressed with them, and they just picked, they picked the perfect time. You know, I wanted the Delta A320, I got the Delta A320. What can I say? I really like the look of the model, though. You're not going to get all the details that you would expect from NG models or Gemini Jets. It is Aero Classics, but, you know, I'm happy enough with their quality, and if they're going to make, you know, models like this that, in my opinion, are in pretty good demand at the moment, then, you know, more to them. But yeah, there's the model there. You can see their tail looks a little bit darker than the Gemini Jets one. I don't know if you can really tell that, but it looks a little bit darker. I'm not really sure what the deal with that is. One of the two manufacturers has got the coloring just a little bit different. And there's the other side, and then we have our, you know, underbelly as we saw before, no Delta logo. we do have that rolling landing gear though, which I like from Aero Classics, and you know, I'm really happy to have this in my collection, so good job from them. Up next, we have another Aero Classics model, and this time it is the United A320. And the big deal with this is obviously the fact that it is in the new livery. And even if it was in the old livery, I think that would still be a pretty big deal, because United A320s are extremely rare. And finding them, in particular the Gemini Jets releases, are just, oh, it's just a pain. It's actually very similar to that Delta 320 situation. So, you know, I was really happy to have another A320, you know, shot to get another A320. And my collection really didn't have, if not any, A320s. So, happy to have this in my collection, finally. I actually got two of these, so that's great. Kind of build up the fleet a little bit. It's in the United new livery, and as you can see, that's kind of what it looks like on an A320. I think it looks pretty good. I'm actually a fan of that. On the other side, just so we can get another view of that. You know, I'm really happy with this model. I think it's good. The livery, like I said, the new tail in particular, I think is probably the biggest thing with this new livery. As you can see, they also add this little dark blue on the edge of the wingtips, if you can see that. Big United titles, you know, which is kind of a new thing, or, you know, been a thing that's kind of been building up this last few years as airlines just kind of getting something more basic, more generic. But you know, bigger titles, just kind of something screaming their logo out. And, you know, maybe that's not a bad idea, I'll tell you. Definitely looks pretty good. Up next, we have yet another Aero Classics model, and it is the 737-900 MAX, or the 737-9 MAX, 9 MAX, whatever you want to call it. Anyways, it's with the typical thing with the wingtips because it's a MAX. Really good model as well. As I said before, you're not going to get, you know, all these, like, NG models, for example. You're not going to get those antennas. You're not going to get all these little markings here, but you're gonna get your decent enough detail, and I'm, you know, for me, I'm happy enough with that. And they are actually the first manufacturers to come out with the 737-9 MAX in the new United livery. So, you know, more power to them. Like I said, you know, coming out with these three models, like these three were perfect for my collection. I actually wanted all three of these, so I was really on the lookout. And I'm sure Gemini Jets or even NG models will come out with a 737-9 MAX or an 8 MAX. With the United, or maybe not the 8, I don't think they ordered the 8, but the 9 MAX. I'm sure Gemini Jets or NG models are going to come out with this model as well. But, you know, for Aero Classics to come out with this and be the first ones to release it, good for them. Very happy with it. So, yeah, nice job with that. And last but not least, we have the NG models 737-800. And this is with the split scimitars, and it obviously comes in the new United livery. And again, this model, oh my gosh, I mean, this model is pretty good. And honestly, when I saw, you know, there are some little things on Instagram, oh yeah, Gemini Jets versus NG models, you know, ha ha ha, NG models comes out first, wait until you get Gemini Jets. But why would you wait? That's kind of what I was asking myself, you know, with my previous issues where a wing has fallen off. I've had, you know, other issues actually where like antennas fall off, and just really just, oh, it's just been so, it just makes me angry. And honestly, when the amount of money we spend on these models and the shipping and all that stuff is such a pain. So I wanted a more reliable manufacturer, and for NG models, which is pretty new to the model scene, to come up with a model like this in this good detail is a serious competitor to Gemini Jets. I mean, it is very, you know, very clear that they are, you know, on the lookout, and especially releasing a model like this, which is in fairly high demand. You know, I would get this as soon as possible. I would not wait for the Gemini Jets one. It is already released by now, but even then, I think the quality with NG models is still going to be even slightly superior to Gemini Jets in this case. So they've been doing such a great job. You know, usually they were releasing 757, so it's what they kind of started off with, but, you know, then they kind of expanded to this A320, you know, 737 realm, and now you're talking mainstream. You know, these models are pretty popular, and, you know, they might sell out. So, you know, get your hands on one while you can. I'm really a fan of the detail. We have that top antenna there. We have that satellite dish. All these details toward the nose is just incredible. I'm really happy with all that. On the back, we have these three red antennas, which is another bonus. You know, I doubt Gemini Jets is going to include those two right there, or maybe they'll include one of them. It's just so good. You know, the quality is great. It's kind of a Phoenix models version. It's just the kind of detail that you expect, and you don't expect these models to come broken, and they didn't. And on top of that, the box actually looks pretty cool too, you know? Just another bonus. Since they come out with like different designs for the boxes and stuff, so it's awesome. It's really awesome, man. So that's pretty much it for this model unboxing, guys. Let me know what you guys think, and what models did you purchase recently? I'm sure you maybe got one of these five if you're interested, particularly that NG models. I mean, my gosh, it is a great one. So looking forward to more releases and more videos to come out on this channel, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you're having a good day, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.